All right, ladies and gentlemen, there, His Excellency the President Uhuru Kenyatta, the President of the Republic of Kenya, and His Excellency Emmanuel Macron, the President of the French Republic. Right, taking a ride on the first ever 3008 Allure from Peugeot, right here, manufactured right here on Kenyan grounds, inevitably giving a boost to the manufacturing pillar under the Big Four agenda.
Monsieur le Président, s'il vous plaît.
Ladies and gentlemen, if we may have our seats, His Excellencies will proceed to the podium to be able to give their address to the media very briefly before they can proceed on to the railway station.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me just once again take this opportunity to once again welcome you, my friend and brother, President Emmanuel Macron, to Kenya, and to say how delighted we are to have you amongst us. Your state visit, being the first by a French president, is most significant and historic in many ways, and I therefore take this opportunity to extend our gratitude for your profound honor to our country. Thank you very much, Mr. President. Welcome. Mr. President, your visit signals our shared commitment to foster our bilateral relations and engagements within the region in various ways which will deepen, expand, and strengthen our bonds of friendship and cooperation for the mutual benefit of our peoples. France continues to be one of the most important contributors to our tourism sector, and we also expect that this visit by President Macron will help increase the number of tourists from France and Kenyans going to France also exponentially. We also expect the visit to impact on the number of French businessmen and investors that would want to invest in Kenya. President Macron himself is accompanied by a large group of businessmen and potential investors who will be meeting with some of our key ministries and other private sector players. I think this is a good day for Kenya and for our development. Today, France is our 17th largest trading partner, and my expectation is that France will grow into an even more important trading partner for Kenya as a result of this visit. Continuing on the journey of building a better Kenya with shared prosperity for all under the Big Four agenda, we have prioritized manufacturing as one of the critical sectors for wealth and employment creation. And as part of our agenda to promote manufacturing, my administration is prioritizing motor vehicle assembly and manufacture of spare parts. Indeed, in furtherance of this agenda, we are greatly encouraged today that the PSA Group, the second largest car manufacturer in Europe, is set to assemble here in Kenya. And I'm happy to say that PSA Group commenced assembling the Peugeot 508 model in June of 2017 at the Kenya Vehicle Manufacturing Limited plant in Thika. And the assembly now of the Peugeot 3008 SUV, which also commenced in September of 2017. Two additional models, the Peugeot 2008 SUV and the Peugeot 308 SW, are envisioned to commence in April and September of this year. I've also been informed that by the end of this year, the PSA Group expects to assemble at least 1,000 vehicles in Kenya, up from the current 480, and this is no doubt very good news for our industry. We are also encouraged to note that with this, when the assembly plant is fully operational, the group hopes to assemble at least 15,000 vehicles annually in Kenya for both local and regional markets. I'm therefore delighted that today, together with my friend President Macron, we have unveiled one of the new models being assembled in Kenya, the Peugeot 3008, right here at State House. And this model was a model that was voted the Car of the Year in 2017. It is a high-performance vehicle with fantastic fuel consumption and the lowest emissions in its class. It is also a hardy vehicle, having been tested in several parts of our country. Going forward, therefore, ladies and gentlemen, I would once again like to restate our policy that is part of our government agenda to promote the philosophy of Buy Kenya, Build Kenya among our people and government. All government entities will, as I have said before, be expected to buy and use locally assembled vehicles and spare parts for all official government use. This policy directive is intended to promote our agenda on manufacturing, creating good jobs for our people, and enhancing technology transfer to our country. Finally, Mr. President, let me once again reiterate and underscore Kenya's commitment to continue working closely with France so as to further deepen, expand, and strengthen our bonds of friendship and cooperation for the mutual benefit of the peoples of our two countries. Karibu, thank you, asante sana. I'd like to hand over to you to say a few words as well now. Thank you very much.
Merci, Monsieur le Président. Je m'exprimerai tout à l'heure en français pour la conférence de presse. Je vais dire quelques mots en anglais. I will switch into English. Thanks very much for your words and for your welcome, Mr. President. As you say, this is the very first time you have a visit of a French president in your country after your independence. And I'm very proud and very happy to be here with you with such a delegation. We are deeply committed in working together with Kenya on different topics. First, security, counter-terrorism, and obviously the regional agenda. We discussed at length about the situation in the region. We work very well together on the situation, but we want to improve the cooperation in the region from a security and defense point of view. And it's obviously what we do through AMISOM in Somalia. But as well through a regional agenda, we discussed at length, and we will follow up this evening. I'm a strong believer in regional stability. I spent a while this morning with President Faki, and I'm a strong believer in the role of African Union, but you yourself are a strong believer of the regional integration, and in such a framework, I think we can deliver much more. This is the very first thing we want to work together on. The second item is indeed to open a new partnership in economy. France was part of your strategy in terms of energy, water, and different topics, but now what we want to do, especially with the delegation of companies, we have with our delegation, what we want to do is to be part of your new growth agenda. So we've just signed a series of agreements, and we will sign tomorrow morning a series of new agreements in order to develop public and private partnerships, and in order to precisely develop new infrastructure projects and very concrete projects to be part of the development of your country, and in order to have a sustainable financing of such concrete projects. This is very important to us, and this is how France could be a long-term, credible economic partner. Beyond economy, what we want to do is as well to be a partner in terms of research and education. We've just signed some agreements, but in total we have 7 agreements on higher education and research, and what we want to do is to expand our cooperation in this field, as it is critical for your domestic strategy, and we want to do the same on health. One last word, and I will be perhaps more complete during the press conference, is about environment. Tomorrow morning we will have the opportunity to meet together with a lot of people for the One Planet Summit and the United Nations. And I think we have a lot of things to do together. You delivered tremendous results regarding the fight against climate change. Your mix now is based on more than 70% on renewables. I want France to work closely with you. That's why we will sign together by tomorrow morning a series of MOU compliant with this strategy, an MOU on infrastructure, an MOU on blue growth, but as well I want France to be a clear contributor to your strategy on grid efficiency in such a context. So thanks very much once again, Mr. President. I'm very happy and very proud indeed to launch this new model, and I think this is how to reconcile the French industry and the excellence of the French industry and your decision to manufacture here. And this is, for me, the best way to embody the philosophy we have together of a clear, balanced partnership. We do believe that our companies and our investors can be part of the growth strategy of your country by providing not just cars, but employment in your country for your people. Thanks very much once again for this visit. This is the very first one, but I can tell you the second one will come soon, as I'm a strong believer in your strategy.
That brings us to the end of this small ceremony. We'll now be able to depart and go to the railway station for another ceremony.